I'm Rachel with Simple Slides. PowerPoint can be used for more than just presentations. In this video, we're going to show you how to make amazing brochures that you can display for your business or organization.
Hi, it's Rachel with Simple Slides. PowerPoint can be used for more than just presentations. In this video, we're going to show you how to make amazing brochures you can display for your business or organization. We're going to build a spaced theme brochure. First, we have to resize our slide into however big we want our brochure to be. For this example, I want the brochure to be the same size as an A4 piece of paper. To do that, simply go to Design, click the inverted triangle under Slide Size, and click on Custom Slide Size. Under the drop-down label, Slide Sizes 4, select A4 paper. Click OK, and the slides will be resized. I inserted a large rectangle shape over the slide, and as you can see, we come up with the actual size, which is 7.5 by 10.83 inches. From this, we can gather that the width of the slide is 10.83 inches. In order to divide the brochure into three, simply divide that number by 3, which will give us 3.61 inches. This will be the width of the three parts. Now we have a rectangle with the height of 7.5 inches and a width of 3.61. Simply copy and paste this shape to create two more duplicates and place them side by side with each other to fill the entire slide. Change the color and outline as desired. Now I want the sections to have a space themed background, so I went online and found this space image from a website called unsplash.com. Simply copy and paste the image into your slide. Since the image is vertical, I went to Format, clicked Rotate, and had the image rotate 90 degrees to the left. Now, here's the tricky part. I want the image to be divided into sections so that it's one continuous picture. There are lots of ways you can do this. Here's how I did it. First, align the image in the center and the middle by going to Format, then Align, and clicking on Align Center and Align Middle. Then copy the image to duplicate it, and have it aligned to the center and middle as well. Make another duplicate and align it to the center and middle. In order to make editing easier, make sure to have three rectangle shapes on top of these three space images. You can place the images backwards by right-clicking on them and clicking Send to Back. Once you have this set up, you can now intersect the shapes with the images. All you have to do is click on the image, hit Control, and click on the shape. That way, both items are selected. Then go to Format, click Merge Shapes, and select Intersect. As you can see, we now have this rectangular shape that has the right part of the image inside. Do the same for the other two shapes. This way, the middle part of the rectangle has the middle part of the image, while the one on the left has the left part of the space image. Once done, you have a space image divided perfectly into three parts. As you can see, there are white lines that divide our brochure. In order to do this, I took the middle part of the sections, clicked on Bring to Front, and added a white outline on the image. That way, we have these white lines that divide our brochure into three. You can also go ahead and add the white outlines to the other two shapes. Now for the fun part, designing the brochure. First, I want to add an image of Earth on this part of the brochure. Like this. Simply look for this image on Google. Copy it and then paste on the slide. Then I resized the image and cropped as necessary. For this glowing rectangle shape, I simply went to Insert the Shapes and selected the rectangle shape. Then I resized and repositioned the shape to my preference. I only want the outline, so I changed the shape fill to no fill and changed the outline to white. Now, for the glowing effect, simply go to Shape Effects, click Glow, and choose the glow that you want the shape to have. I chose this blue. Now, to spice up the word space that's inside the rectangle outline, go to Insert, click Shapes, and look for Text Box. Inside the text box, type in the word you want and choose the font you want. I chose the font called Arial Black. Just like our rectangle shape, I gave it no fill and a white outline. Resize and reposition as desired. You can also give it a glow by going to Format, click Text Effects, and then select Glow, and pick out the effect that you want. Here's a neat trick to center our text to the rectangle outline. Simply click the text, then hit Control, and click on the shape you want it aligned. Then go to Format under Align and select Align Center and Align Middle. Here, I did some more resizing and repositioning until I got the look that I want. Now you can add more text as you desire. I'm just going to copy the ones at the bottom, but it's basically the same principle of adding text boxes and editing your text by resizing, changing the font, recoloring, and adding the text effects that you want. I also added 3 stars at the bottom. This was done by going to Insert, clicking Shapes, and then selecting the star shape from there. I made sure to lock the aspect ratio by clicking on the star, going to Format Shape, and checking the Lock Aspect Ratio box. This way, I'll have the perfect star shape, no matter the size. Being consistent with the theme, I set the shape color to No Fill and added a white outline, and selected a thinner outline width. I also added the glow effect to the star, and this time, it's a golden color. You can now resize and reposition the star and duplicate it so you have 2 other stars beside it. Here's a neat trick that I do instead of copying and pasting. Simply right-click on the shape and hold it while dragging it to any position. Once you release the button, you can then click on Copy Here from the option. Make sure to center and align the 3 stars. You can add other elements to your brochure, such as text, shapes, and images. As you can see here, I'm adding a logo to the lower right end of the brochure. Now for the middle part of the brochure. First, let's add the word company next to our logo. It's basically the same principle as adding text to a text box and editing it to your preference. This time, I used the font Babys Noia and even set the character spacing to very loose. I also retained the same aesthetic of having no fill plus white outline, just like earlier. I also added the glow. For the logo, I first created a circle shape by going to Insert, then Shapes. I also made sure to lock the aspect ratio, so it's still a perfect circle when resized. Then, just like the other shapes, I gave it no fill and then a white outline, as well as the glow effect. Once done, I simply add in another copy of the logo. Make sure the logo is in the center of the circle. After making sure the text and the logo are at the top center of the brochure, I move on to creating this rectangle shape with 2 lines on its sides. Simply create a rectangle shape, give it no fill, and a white outline. Then the glow effect. I also added a text inside, which I made sure to align at the center and middle of the rectangle. Now, for the lines on its left and right sides, go to Insert, click Shapes, and look for Line. Create a horizontal line and attach it to either side of the rectangle. Change the outline color to white and give it a glow effect similar to the rectangle. Then, simply duplicate the line to the other side. I also added a bunch of text below which represents some more information about our company. Feel free to add other things as well. Now I want to add some icons below, as well as some text to accompany them. First, I add the circles with no fill, white outline, and the glow effect. Afterwards, it's time to add the icons. But there's only one problem for me. My PowerPoint 2013 doesn't seem to have icons under the Insert tab on the ribbon above. So, what I did was open the Simple Slides template called Creative that contains these amazing pre-made slides, which includes these 2 slides that have a bundle of icons ready for use. All we have to do now is add some glow effects to them, just like our sample brochure. To speed things up, let's just copy the ones here and paste it inside our circle. Then, let's go ahead and copy these texts here. I've also added a portion below where you can add contact information and other details. Remember, you can customize this brochure however you want and can add other things here, such as text, shapes, or even images. And now for our final panel. The first thing I want to add is this giant cropped moon peeking at the edge. I simply searched for an image in Google, copied it, and then pasted it onto the slide. Then I resized and positioned the moon on the lower left edge of the panel and cropped it to my liking. I also added these icons with text below. It's pretty much the same process. So I grouped these shapes and text and then copied them to our panel. Make sure to have it centered. For the final element, I inserted a rectangle shape and placed it from the leftmost side of the top part of the panel, as if it were a little ribbon peeking from the page. I changed the color to yellow and gave it no outline colors. Then I added text inside, making sure it's properly sized, and moved it to the position I desired. And there you have it. A simple but effective space-themed brochure made only using Microsoft PowerPoint. Remember, this brochure is fully customizable, and you can mix and match whatever text, shapes, and images that you desire. Subscribe, like, and comment what other tutorials you want to see on future Simple Slides videos. Thanks to XXIs for this tutorial. Check out his channel in the description for more PowerPoint videos.